Hi, welcome to our very first actual episode of the Pottery Pod podcast. In this episode, we're going to be going through it pretty quick because I'm going to actually show how to do a bonsai tray or bonsai pot from start to finish. Here I'm centering about 2.5 to 3 pounds of clay. You can make this particular project any size you want. Once you get your clay centered, go ahead and open up your well in the center of the clay. And I'm using a kind of a high grog raku clay here that can go up to cone 6, so it can do stoneware temperatures. Once you have your well opened up, simply take both hands and pull straight towards you, leaving about 1/4 inch, if not 3/8 inch of clay at the bottom, and make sure and keep that level of clay all the way from the center all the way to the edge. And then I like to go ahead and compress the clay at the bottom. Once your clay has been compressed at the bottom, go ahead and take the edge and pull it out even further, depending on how wide you want your bonsai pot. I kind of want this one a fairly medium-sized bonsai pot. And so I'm going to keep pulling back towards myself until that level of clay, that 3/8 to a quarter to 3/8 inches, all the way even. I'm going to take the edge of my rib, a nice stiff wooden edge, and I'm going to compress the clay even further and even cut slightly into the edge so that it's nice and smooth. Now I'm going to take the very edge, the ring of clay that's left over, and I'm going to dig my fingers under on the outside and push my fingers on the inside and simply pull up, keeping my hands together just like throwing normally, and pull it up slow and easy and get just a little bit more height, because you couldn't get your knuckle under there if you had to. And now I'm going to go ahead and keep my hands together and just go ahead and use the tips of my finger for the knuckle and inside fingertips holding, and go ahead and just pull it up like any other pot, pulling slightly outward. This is the same way that you would do any kind of a plate, except we're not going to lay the edge over. We're just going to go ahead and keep pulling straight up on it. And go ahead and get another little ring of clay at the bottom and just keep pulling up with your fingernails. Not your fingernails, that'd be good. Just keep pulling up with your fingertips. And as you pull up, go ahead and see how much height that you want on the piece. You know, if you wanted a narrow, short little bonsai pot, I'm going to go ahead and round off the rim here. And after I round off the rim, I'm going to take my wooden rib and I'm going to put like a mark or a dent in the very bottom right next to the bat so that the wire tool will have something to grab onto and glide over with, so that it won't ride up. Now I'm going to just take the edge of the wooden rib and I'm going to lay it against the outside of the pot, and I'm going to push with my fingers on the inside of the pot, and I'm just going to gently make a concave surface, just letting the tool follow in a rounded shape while I continue to push with my fingers lightly on the inside of the pot. I'm going to go ahead and work on my lip a little bit more here and make sure it's nice and smooth, and I think I'll go ahead and put a little line feature just right at the top here, about an inch down, so that the glaze will have someplace nice to pool. And there's pretty much your bonsai pot. At the very base here, that's where we're going to be cutting it off. Don't spin the wheel. Just simply take your wire tool and tighten it very tight. Push it to the bat with both of your thumbs, and simply slide it real slow until it comes all the way out to the other end. Don't rush it, because we don't want the wire tool to ride up and, you know, cut into the pot. We want it to stay on the bat. And then take your bat off and set the pot off to dry in order for it to get leather hard, and then we'll be working with it some more. In order to make the feet, I'm going to go ahead and just simply center about a pound or slightly less of clay, and I'm just going to open up a well. You can open this well all the way up to the bat. It doesn't matter, because these are going to be feet. But if you do, go ahead and leave a little skin of clay at the very bottom, because if you pull all the clay away from it and then continue to pull the ring of clay out towards your body, that clay will actually come off of the bat and turn into this spinning ribbon of death. And so you want to try to keep the clay as a disc on the bat for as long as possible. So go ahead and keep just a little bit of a skin of clay down there, and we're basically just pulling this little ring of clay the same way we did the initial bonsai pot, with a couple of fingers and just kind of keep pulling it towards you. We don't really have to open this particular piece of clay up as much as we did with the bonsai pot, because the feet aren't going to be as wide. And so we go ahead and just open up kind of a little edge, and I'm flattening out that edge, and I'm actually going to take a I'm actually going to take a tool here and flatten it, because these are all going to be feet. We're basically just going to cut sections out of this for the feet. Go ahead and flatten that, and then you can go ahead and take that excess clay out once you actually have the ring pulled to the distance you want. And then I'm going to clean up the wheel and maybe put a little I've cleaned up the rest of this clay first, and then I'm going to go ahead and maybe put like just a little mark on the edge, because this is going to be the side that actually shows on the bonsai pot, and another little line that kind of mimics the one that we put in there. We're going to speed dry this one with one of these heavy duty paint stripper guns. I'm actually going to force it into leather hardness, and that's why I use Masonite bats a lot, because the Masonite bats can take a lot of heat. So about 3 minutes of doing this on a very low speed, and you can see how the bat has changed colors. It's almost completely dry, and this is nice and leather hard now. You can actually feel how stiff it is. It's not too stiff to work with, though, and that's good, because we want to try to keep him that way. I'm going to draw a line right through the center and make a mark on either side with my wire tool. Then I'm going to crisscross a line right through the other center and make another line, so I've divided it into quarters. And then I'm going to divide those quarters into halves, so we end up with 8 little marks. And now you can continue to cut all the way through with the wire tool. I like to use something sharp, like this little little palette knife that I've used forever, and it's extremely sharp. So I'm just going to cut straight down to the bat and then pull towards me. It makes it easier with a knife, especially if you're using a high grogged clay. Once you've got all of your quadrants cut out, then you can go ahead and take your wire tool, whether you want to spin the wheel slowly or just simply take the wire tool and cut all the way across, freeing all of your little sections. And now, lo and behold, you have all of these nice little feet. And you probably have quite a few more than you're going to use, so I always just save them, do a couple of projects with one ring of clay. Makes it pretty handy. Once your bonsai pot has been leather hard dried and you've removed it from the bat, we did wire it off, go ahead and invert it, stick it on a bat, and then take some plugs of clay and secure it into place with these plugs of clay. And we're not going to be trimming an excessive amount, so I'm just going to take a simple pear-shaped loop tool, and I'm just going to trim this edge off right here. I'm going to make it a little bit more rounded, and we're just basically finishing it up. We're taking off the rough edge of it. We're not really going to remove a whole lot of clay at all. And it's still pretty soft, so we don't want to dig too far into it. Once you've used your loop tools or your cutting tools and have removed the clay, you can take all manner of smoothing tools, either some of these silicone rubber ribs, or maybe you can take your metal kidney and smooth that grog back down. You really can't see it in the video, but this grog is pretty heavy on this this clay body, and it looks a little like concrete, so I'm smoothing it out. But be careful when you smooth out the bottom, because it's, you know, you could actually convex it all the way back down too far. So now that we've got our bonsai pot smoothed out, now we're going to attach our feet. And what you need to do is just simply take the feet and place them where they're basically going to go. If the if you found out that your circumference isn't quite exactly the right diameter, you can take the feet and bend them so that they'll fit. Once you get your feet placed where you want them, I always take just a little wire tool like this, and I will mark the feet where they go. I'll also take maybe a fan brush or an old brush, and that's what we're going to apply the slip onto the feet with. I usually just use the slip that's out here in the splash pan. It's fine as long as I've been using the same clay body. I've never had a problem doing that, so that's what we're going to be doing. So I usually take the little wire tool, and I'll go ahead and just mark the areas where the feet were, and then I score the backside. And don't be chintzy and don't be afraid, just go ahead and score them up pretty good, and then go ahead and score the surface also of the pot. Especially if you're going to do this in a raku process, because the first thing that's going to pop off of here in a raku process is the feet. And then take a little slip, and I can't really see it in the camera here, I'll lower it here in just a second. Take the slip and paint the backside of your foot, and go ahead and place it on the roughed up area, and just firmly place it into place and put some pressure on the top of it. Not real heavy, just enough to maybe see a little of the slip squirt through. And go ahead and do the other 4 feet. Nice even work schedule here. There's nothing too thrilling. Nice production work. And then score the actual surface of the bonsai pot. You've scored the foot. You can take a little slip out of the slurry bucket. If you like, you can mix up your own slip to be used for the specific purpose. I'm kind of lazy. And then we'll take that foot and we will place it once again on the bonsai pot. And like I said, a nice firm amount of pressure to where you can see some of the slip squirt through is what you need. Once you've got all the feet in place, go ahead and take a little water or slip and kind of go around the edges of all the feet so that you can kind of close up any little gaps that might be open. You can take your fingernail, you can take a wooden tool and burnish those edges down a little bit. Don't bother burnishing the edges of these feet, the ends of these feet just yet, because I'm going to be showing you a little technique that will, you know, undo any work that you're getting ready to do there. So once you've actually smoothed that out, I'm going to go ahead and take my wire tool. I'm just going to mark these at about a 3/4 inch in on either side. 1 and 2. And do every one of them that way. And what we're going to do is we're just going to cut down and to the side in a scalloping movement so that we've kind of cut the foot into a little triangle. Can't really see that too well on this foot. Let's take a look at it a little bit better on the front one. And just kind of make a scallop move. And that's really nice because when you look at it in profile, you'll see that those 2 feet make a nice arch under the pot. It's just a nice decorative aspect. Now, once you get all of those cleaned up and cut the way you want, then you can take your finger or the paintbrush or whatnot and you can smooth off the edges. You know, rub a little bit of slip on them to polish them up a little bit. And that's pretty much all there is to it. Most bonsai pots actually have 2 holes in them. They are flower pots. So we're going to take a dime-sized piercing tool, one of these sharp brass tools, and I'm going to come in about maybe an inch and a half, 2 inches from this foot, and I'm going to bore a hole. And then I'm going to look at that hole and see if there's any concentric rings that follow that hole from when I threw it, follow that concentric ring over to the other side, so I know it's exactly equidistant to the other one. And I'm going to pierce that one too. Place your seal or your name on the piece. This actually hardened up quite a bit when I was working with the paint stripper gun, so I'll have to press that a little harder. And there you have pretty much your finished bonsai pot. Before we lift it up and show you, the easiest way is to take another bat, clean one preferably, place it on top and simply flip the piece over. That way the weight of the actual pot will help hold the feet into place while they dry. And make sure it dries slowly. And there you have quite a nice bonsai pot. Later on we'll show you how to do an oval one. It's pretty easy. You can put marks on the side of it. We'll show you that one in a later section. Thanks for watching and stay tuned next time.